What with the time?
We go from a sleepy Cassidy to awake John Candy there in the movie Cool Runnings. Yeah, we're talking Olympic classics as we get ready for the games to start this week. Dustin Morrow from Portland State University, a professor of film, joins us to run down his three Olympic favorites. Cool Runnings obviously made the list,
yeah,
Dustin.
These are my three Winter Olympics favorites. There's so many great movies about the Olympics, but yeah,
reminisce about Cool Runnings a little bit.
Yeah, well, Cool Runnings is a heavily fictionalized version of the story of the first Jamaican bobsled team, of course, competed in Calgary. It was the second to last performance by John Candy. It's generally remembered as a comedy, and it is, but it also has a lot of sort of moving dramatic moments, and it's some of the best work as a dramatic actor that John Candy ever did.
I have seen this movie, and I loved it. I didn't remember the title, but no, I love this movie. Now.
Everybody loves this movie.
Yeah,
that's a great one. Miracle, another one. So tell us about this movie. Yeah. I haven't seen that one.
Oh, really? No. Miracle is about is generally considered the greatest moment in American sports history, which is, of course, the Miracle on Ice at the 1980 Lake Placid Olympics, where the U.S. team, which was comprised entirely of amateur college players, managed to beat the greatest hockey team in history, the unbeatable Russian hockey team.
So what's the word on this film? Do you hear that it very closely followed actual events, or did Hollywood drift off a little bit?
No, it's really close, and in fact, it kind of had to be because it's such a documented event. There have been multiple documentaries and about six or seven narrative movies made about this. It's one of the most covered sports events ever. This is probably the best version of it you'll ever see.
Is it one of those, Dustin, where they take us back with clips of the real event and then sort of intercut with modern day?
I think it's all recreated,
actually.
Yeah, because just they didn't have the technology back then to produce images that you could actually show in a theater and have it hold up.
It is so powerful, though.
It is. Kurt Russell's amazing in it.
I have seen it, but I can't remember it that well. And I saw it. It was one of those you want to get up at the end and cheer.
Oh, yeah.
Like a Rocky moment, you know, very much so. Yeah. And your final selection, I have not seen this one, but heard great things about Eddie the Eagle.
Eddie the Eagle, yeah, it's recent. It came out one or two years ago, and it's the true story of Eddie Edwards, who was a British kid who dreamed of being in the Olympics, but had absolutely no athletic skill or prowess whatsoever. And so he decided that the event that he might be able to pull off was the ski jump. And he made it to he actually qualified for the 1988 Winter Olympics, despite a lot of efforts by the British government to keep him out of the Olympics because they felt he was sort of demeaning the sport because he wasn't serious about it.
Now this movie, I hear, they did add some characters
comedic
to play with
license,
it a little bit.
Perhaps.
But it's a wonderful story.
It is, yeah. Hugh Jackman is hilarious in it, plays his coach. Like the other two movies we just mentioned, it's a great underdog story.
Yeah. Any of these suitable for families, all of them?
All three of them.
All of them?
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. And I think all of them are on Netflix now, or at least two of them are. So easy to watch them and get pumped for the Olympics later this week. Yeah.
Again, Dustin's selections, Cool Runnings, Miracle, and Eddie the Eagle. Thanks so much for coming by.
Yeah, of course.